Welcome back to Into the Breach. We just got done saving the galaxy in the other run of FTL Faster Than Light. Now, let's save the planet Earth. A little bit more localized. Today we're going to be taking out the Mist Eaters, which is apparently a very smoke-themed squad, and I've heard rumors that this is very powerful. So let's take a look at our equipment. Sure. So, this is kind of a reverse of the charging, like the charge mech, the engines that make you ram into an enemy. This time you run away from them real far, I guess. And you can extend the possible range on this. So I guess this is actually kind of like the railgun, too. But you can smoke the enemy, too, rather than pushing it. So this does not push the enemy. It smokes it. That's both good and bad. It means we're not going to be able to instantly kill enemies by dunking them into environmental hazards. But at the same time, it's limited collateral damage, so far as this has a runway to travel along. Then this, I think we actually saw in an earlier run. This was an extremely powerful artillery shot. You can't push enemies with this again, but you can either smoke or set on fire as the situation requires. And having both of those as options on a single weapon is going to be really handy. And then this one, which is apparently one of the stronger science weapons in the game. You don't even need any power for it. You can just make the enemies go exactly where you want them to. Limited to their own movement abilities, though. So unlike the SWAT mech, you can't move enemies through mountains or over chasms or anything like that. And I imagine you can't just order a scorpion to march to its death into water or pits, like I said. But there's certainly a lot of shenanigans we can get up to with this one. So let's see, I don't have any particular time traveler in mind for this one. Certainly I'd like to get these two unlocked. I kind of already know who they are. I've seen them in other posts and videos and whatnot. But I certainly would like to get them on camera. But we won't be picking our last traveler. Let's just randomize and see who the game gives us. It could be very generous or very rude. What have we got, game? Bethany. Sure. Fair enough. Which of these is most vulnerable to getting webbed? This is a melee range attack, so even if the control mech gets webbed, like by a Leaper or something, it's probably not in actually that much danger, because it could just control the Leaper and make it go somewhere else, right? We might actually want to put a shield on the thruster mech, just so that, like, this has to go to a specific place in order to do the most damage possible, and I could certainly imagine it needing to jet away from one enemy and intercept another enemy's shot or melee attack or projectile or something. So having that survivability on this mech, like, I usually try to put shields on things that are going to be doing those kinds of interceptions. So I think that makes sense. You can stay here. No other real configuration we need to do. Let's check out the achievements real quick before we head out. I guess we'll be healing with this thing. Alright, we can do that. We're going to need to really upgrade this, but I'm sure we can just get that during... As long as we do a four-island run, we should be fine for this one. And as long as we upgrade this to full, we should be fine on this one. So if we do a four-island run, I'm sure we'll get all of these. And we'll stick with these categories for now. Hard, like, advanced enemy units and hard mode is plenty of challenge for me. You know, depending upon whether you get bouncers or, like, starfish are not usually so bad, depending upon the map layout. But if we get, like, a moth and tumblebug island, then that's plenty enough challenge for me. I'm fine with that. We're not going to go up to unfair quite yet. That'll be several runs in the future. Let's just try out all the squads first. Alright, let's head out there. I think we've pretty much covered everything we want to do, so... We don't have electric smoke. That's the domain of the other squad, the Rusting Hulks. But we are going to be laying down a lot of smoke to cancel enemy attacks. Our direct damage is a little bit iffy. This is always depending upon friendly fire. I guess we'll also want to probably move enemies into fire tiles or other enemies' attacks for the time being. Eventually, we might get a secondary weapon for this, but for the time being, to really actually get enemies killed, it's going to take some effort to actually kill enemies. So I guess, still, as per usual, we want to look for 1 HP enemies, or 2 HP, anything that we can easily get smoke on. I think this island should actually be pretty friendly to us. Fire immunity won't be that bad for what we're trying to accomplish here. And this squad gets rid of smoke and repairs it, so mosquitoes that lay smoke down on top of us for free are basically doing our job for us. It's kind of ridiculous. We're invalidating an entire species of Vec just by virtue of our equipment. Some of these other options aren't too bad, but again, I do want to try and avoid the armor or the arachnid until later on when our action efficiency is going to be a little bit better. So it would probably come down to either this or this, and an island full of 3 HP enemies, including the moth, is nowhere near as attractive as a bunch of low HP enemies and one that we're directly counteracting. So, yeah, we should have nothing to worry about Leaper and Mosquito combo purely because of the squad we're playing. Incredible. To counterbalance this, Zenith has seen fit to force us to take an extremely easy mission with low rewards, but somehow I think we'll be okay. So I guess our best bet, if we want to maximize the number of rep we get, is to go this way and take all three of these missions. That way we can at least take, two of these. I guess we could go this way and take this one, and also this way and take this one. But let's start out with just a nice simple one. There's not really any other reason to... There's no cores here, there's no otherwise very easy missions that we can see. So, I guess we'll start out with this one. An incredibly easy one. Doubly easy. This one is already usually real simple by default, just spawning two enemies per turn. Which, I don't think any other mission in the game is that polite to. And we have some free shielded buildings, too. Some pretty good ones to be shielded as well. So we're going to be a little bit cramped due to all of these actually being on the board at the same time, but I think we should be fine here. Let's see if we can get all the enemies killed. That would be very convenient. Alright, looks like max range is 2. So much like the other jet mech, having some sort of... putting like Chen or Archimedes on this thing would be very handy. Jet away from an enemy and then use your bonus move to get back into the center. But we don't have that quite yet. So there's two ways we could get this killed. We could do that or that. So I guess really the question is just where do we want to put smoke? And I guess that's a pretty good place to put smoke. These kinds of inside corners. And this is a perfectly fine place to keep you for the time being. On the other hand, if I use the jet... the thruster to kill you, then you wind up right here, which is a little bit better. So I guess this is probably a better way of doing it. And then, can you control a frozen enemy? No, of course not. Had to check, though. Sometimes you can, but not this time. Gotta just check these things. Okay. I'm going to assume that the attack stays in the same direction relevant, like, relative to the enemy, so it's going to keep firing along the six column, or six row, whichever one of these counts as a column or row in this isometric context. So yeah, there's not really much for you to do this turn. Oh, also this is flying. Yeah, we have two flying mechs, actually. By default. So that's actually ridiculous. That's better than usual. Well, I guess if we're going to get that achievement going, we might as well at least try and do something with it. Oh, it's one self-damage. Okay, I missed that during the tooltip. But it was there. plain to see all this time. Well, I guess we get a bonus damage that way. Alright, so this actually does have the charge mech problem then. Alright. I guess the whole point of the repair is to be able to incidentally repair this thing every now and then. We certainly want to light this one on fire. That's how we're going to get a lot of damage on this thing. So we'll go ahead and get started on that one. And then which of you goes first? This does. I was kind of hoping I could have this get hit first and then this one hit the other one. We also actually don't want to smoke this thing because it'll put out the fire. So we'll want to wait one turn on that. I guess this is fine, though. Like, just light that on fire, and then maybe we break this ahead of time. We're really putting ourselves in the corner this way, but... Yeah, that might actually be putting too many enemies out on the field at the same time if we let that go. So I think we do want this one to get killed. So... Now this will get killed. This will effectively be dead. This will be at 2 HP and be on fire, so you should be easily able to get one damage in on it. And then we have control mech in the area to move this thing around manually if we need to. I'm a little concerned about these laser bots in the back activating. Well, actually, I know. Yeah, these are the only ones that are going to be spawning. But I think we have enough... Like, there's only three enemies that we need to care about. This one might be an obstacle, but that's it. And we have three actions, so we should be okay. Alright, great. This one actually took the bait. I'll take it. Alright. And it's a good thing I had this far up, because neither the thruster mech nor the smog mech could actually reach it. That's also something to keep in mind. Hold on, can I, Ooh, I can get bonus move, if I waste this weapon, I can get this one to move two over. Okay, that could be pretty handy, and we're getting this one for free. I don't even have to do anything to you. Excellent. Alright, looks like we don't have to do anything particularly fancy this time. Just moving you down here should be enough. And, if I'm understanding this correctly, yes, so we can put smoke here. Which would normally be bad for any other squad, but on this one, it turns into a free repair action, so... Actually, it's just good. Alright, I think I'm starting to understand what people are saying about this sort of thing. Like, the pilot, Camilla Vera, her special ability is being able to act in smoke. Everybody here can act in smoke. For free. And it repairs them, so it's good for them. So, this squad is going to be going places, I'm sure. Guess we might as well get a little bit more, grind this objective a little bit more, I guess. Put out that smoke and put out that fire and repair you at the same time. Yeah, of course. Alright, we're only scratching the surface here. This is only the beginning. So, yeah, we obviously, given the self-damage criteria, there's multiple ways of working around it. Clearly the healing will help out with that. Doesn't look like you can upgrade this, though, so no absurd, moving into a smoke repairing you too. That would be ridiculous. So yeah, lots of different pilots would help out with this. Just any pilot with plus 2 HP would be excellent here. Bethany's kind of doing the same thing as plus 2 HP, sort of. We can use this 3 times in a row before that's a problem. In fact, actually, I think because of the way this works, or no, because of the way this works, I think we could... It looks like it self-damages you as soon as you activate the attack. So I think we could, with our last HP, if we were at 1 HP, we could reverse thruster out of smoke. In fact, I can even demonstrate this. Yeah, so if we're here, this will kill us, and then it will revive us in the smoke. I'm not sure why it revived us to Fool. That might just be an artifact of, Wait a minute, hold on. Okay, that just might be an artifact of the training room or something. Yeah, it looks like whenever you kill your own mech, it just revives to Fool, so... Presumably what will actually happen in the game is you will die and then get revived at 1 HP. But that's still plenty. That's enough for our purposes. Ooh, robot factories. That could be pretty tough on this squad. The smoke would help to an extent with that, to help kind of group up the enemies where we want, but you really want, pushing. You want collision damage to help deal with those robots easily. And that's the one thing this squad is really lacking. We're gonna need to get some secondary weapons that actually help out with that kind of thing. Ice Storm could also be tough. We're kind of... Our one source of, like, really heavy passive damage is the fire from this thing. And the ice is going to put that out, so it's not really going to help us out. We're kind of going to be grinding down enemies by, like, getting individual hits on them. Maybe, like, our biggest damage is actually going to come from this, and it's really incidental. So this might be the exact wrong mission for us to take. Killing 7 enemies in an ice storm can be hard, even for prepared squads. We might actually, for once, want to go around with this one, especially if it's an ice mines mission. Okay, let's try that one out. People love to hate this one, but you know what? We have stalling tactics, so this might just be perfect for us. Let's get the smog mech out of the way, and something like this should be pretty good. You're the one, as usual, the artillery one is the one that we don't want webbed, but we can deal with being webbed on either of these two and be fine. And smoke immunity is not going to do much. Well, fire immunity. If I remember right, the way that the fire immunity scion works is that it protects Vec from fire damage. So they still actually do get lit on fire. The fire just doesn't actually apply damage to them. But if this thing ever dies, then all of a sudden they're on fire still because they were still on fire to begin with. And they will start taking damage from it. Additionally, I'm not 100% sure of this. I think the way the AI works is that even with this in effect, I think the enemy still tries to avoid going onto fire tiles because they aren't aware that they have the buff. So I think we can still use fire as area denial, I think, if I remember right. So we have 2 potential mechs that could go to cover this tile. We've got good coverage of here, here, and here, and wherever these go. I mean, it's 3-on-3, and possibly even 2-on-3 if we get lucky. Or 3-on-2. So we should be fine. So where possible, I guess we want to just mind control enemies into going onto the... just going onto the... These things, right? Yeah, so I guess what we want is something like... Where would I actually like fire to be? I guess here. I'll kill one of these, and then I... Well, I guess we'll kill both of these. They're really annoying to actually leave alive. But we'll certainly control one of these to go somewhere else. I don't think we want to block a spawn on the first turn, but blocking a spawn on the second turn could be very useful. So I guess we'll control you, or no, we'll control you, and then I guess we will jet over here after all. Being lit on fire could be pretty bad, but at the same time, if we revive ourselves, it might not necessarily be a problem. On the other hand, I think the next turn is going to be pretty quiet anyway, with only two enemies coming up, so it might be okay to put you back here. I'll try it. I'll put this here. Or here, just in case it's a distraction for this or something. Sure. Alright, artillery units should be easy to manipulate with this thing. Alright, now we want to start blocking spawns, I think. We've already killed two enemies, but if we can convince you to go here, it should be alright. Because I want to kill this eventually anyway, and then we... Well, Yeah, we can't... Well, we can go here. Okay. I was about to say we couldn't block a spawn with this, but we can. So, I'm wrong. We can do that. Sure. So, it is still on fire. It's not going to take damage from that, but we can make use of that. And there's our free turn. We have two more turns left, and we can freely use those on those two remaining turns. This is the one turn this didn't do anything. Okay, that's fine. Enemies freezing themselves is exactly what we want on this mission. That is perfectly okay. Okay, I think we just need to block one more spawn and we're basically there, right? Yeah, so we can repair ourselves that way. We'll block this spawn. And we're allowed to kill another enemy if we want. Like, we can kill one more enemy. Well, not like that we can. I guess this would have been the one to hit then, but I don't think we had enough range to do that with, so... I guess this would have been the one to kill then. So this one is gonna die, that one will burn eventually, so that gets us to four, and we're basically there, so we'll just... Let's just end the mission. We will fulfill the letter of our contract and call it a day. Alright, and we'll just let that one burn. Hold on, no. If we're gonna grind that objective, I guess we really want to get to work with this, right? Yeah. Gonna get there steadily, but, journey of 1,000 miles begins with two single steps. Oh, actually I was kill five or fewer, so we could have killed one more. Could have gotten experience points. That's fine. Alright. Well, this actually felt pretty thematic. Like, people usually don't like this one where it's like, aren't you supposed to be winning the war by killing the enemy? But in this case, it actually makes sense. If you're trying to stall for time or make the enemy recover their own, you know, waste their medical capabilities or whatnot, or test out the ice mines, that at least makes a certain amount of sense. Like, the Zenith is providing you with mission support for that objective. Okay. For some reason, the hacking facility is actually shielded, but I guess it was a pretty important one. This raises a lot of questions. The Vec have not previously been shown to be able to infiltrate technology, but I suppose that's what they're up to here. Maybe it's that bot leader at work there. Yeah, let's try this one out. This is one we haven't actually seen yet on camera, so let's go ahead and take a look at that one. So don't kill that, but it does start shielded, so that's also pretty convenient. So I guess we'll need someone who can tank one damage and fire, so somebody who has a lot of HP, I guess. It'll probably be you. And otherwise, yeah, just make this one waste its turn. In fact, what would be amazing would be if we could distract this into... Yeah, just make this block this one's shot. So that's why I'm not deploying on this column, even though that would normally be a good idea. I want to lure this into being able to shoot up here and not down here where that will become impossible. Well, so far so good. Actually, you have a shield, so you're even better suited to that job, if need be. Alright, good. I think things are happening exactly as I thought they would. Excellent. Alright, I'll take it. Oh, thanks, game. We'll become friendly. Ooh, fancy. Well, let's get to work on that then, huh? So, this looks like... Yeah, this is actually technically a unit. It's a stable unit like the terraformer or the disposal unit, rather than being a building. Like, this has a grid power on it. This does not technically use grid power. Which is good. I guess Zenith managed to disconnect it from the grid or something. So I guess the idea here is we do this, of course. That's what we spent all that time setting up. Also, thankfully, it looks like this doesn't get Scion bonuses. Good. I would certainly be very worried if a building got Scion bonuses, but there you go. Nevertheless, we will kill this. And then this should do the job. We're going to hit it for one damage and then light it on fire. It is on fire. Yep. Alright. That'll deal with needing two independent actions. Oh, but I canceled its attack. Okay, I guess that makes a certain degree of sense. I thought it was going to be on our side next turn. But I guess it just gets freed up immediately. And I guess that saves you if you couldn't block its action from taking place or something. On the other hand, now it's 4-on-3, so we should be fine. This is hard mode. This is, in fact, hard mode. Alright, so we can't drown any of these, but we could kill two of these units and be okay. And then just, kill this one, kill this one, and then just move this one somewhere else. Like, in fact, actually... Oh, I'm really gonna want the movement upgrade on this thing, because once I can just send enemies to the back lines such that they're too far away from the cities to attack them, they'll be stuck on a loop of attacking our own mechs rather than being able to go out front to the cities again. I think going back here is still enough, though. This only has 4 moves, so from here... 4 move goes here, 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 and here, like in this diamond shape, so that's enough. So going back here is still enough to get done what we need to get done. Also, you have enough power to do this too. You kill an enemy. So I guess we might as well kill this enemy then, right? So here's what I'm thinking. Go here, light this on fire. Go here, jet this way, once you've moved, to kill this. Control this back here, and then the cannon bot will go all the way down here and shoot this. So that way we'll destroy this ice tile, which will block any terrestrial Vec from being able to do anything. And you'll be a useful distraction down here. We should still be able to rescue you if necessary. On the other hand, you could also move here, and it would be easier to protect you from that spot, so I think we'll do that instead. You don't need to be that close to the enemy. I don't want you to get surrounded. That would be a hassle. So that makes sense. This makes sense. We are going to smoke that, but that's all right. And then we will kick off of this. So now the situation is under control. It's 4-on-4, and this one is nearly dead. So this does not get the smoke immunity, so that does have the risk of happening, but we have enough action economy that it's still fine anyway. It'll take a little bit of work to clean this up, but we are still going to get there. In fact, this one is just wasting its turn, so everything is actually quite good. Yeah, so that'll die if we ignore it just one turn, so I guess the play is just move this back here or something. Or over here. I kind of want you to be able to shoot you, but that's only going to be possible if you can move. Well, okay, I guess we will go ahead and do just that then. Oh, interesting. It did actually jump. So we'll actually use the Vex's own movement type for that. Good to know. Alright, this all looks good to me. I haven't even taken any damage on this thing yet. So it's a frontliner now. Oh, they're trying. They're trying to make this all work. It's not going to, though. Here. Well, it can't from smoke, though. So we'll just have to move it somewhere else. Like, just back up. Here. Here, let's see if we can recover any of those hacking facility parts. No? No, they're all gone? Alright, well, this seems to have a very, very strong Island 1. The difficulty curve of this game is a little bit more complicated than in FTL. Still, the principle usually applies that Island 1 is the hardest one. And our base equipment is doing fine. Sure, I'll absolutely take that for free. It might be the worst of the tanks, but it's better than nothing. Which of these would I actually want to do? Which one would I not want to be using its main weapon on? I guess this one, then. On the one turn in which I don't want to use reverse thrusters or it's inappropriate, instead we fire the shield tank. That makes sense. Still, though, I think we do still want to improve our direct damage where possible. Just having an option to get 3 damage on one enemy would be extremely handy, so I think we do want that, right? It's not going to improve our, it's not going to affect our self-damage. That'll still be 1 even with this, but we do have to move 3 tiles away to actually make this happen, so that is worth worrying about. Still, though, 3 is an incredibly important breakpoint, so I think it's worth going for it. Okay, so now we can do the robot factories. We can't quite actually power this yet, but we will be able to eventually. And I guess this will be the ultimate test of the squad's powers, is can it handle this mission out of the gate, out of its base state? Well, I guess we probably actually do want this to be here, because if it gets webbed, we can kill it in one hit. On the other hand, it could go over here. We need to be ready for that sort of thing. So we probably actually want the control mech over here, and then you need to have good access to a whole bunch of different rows. But this should be pretty good. You should be able to kill the mosquitoes wherever they go, and you have the opportunity to take some shots at this to either light it on fire or smoke it if it goes over here and for whatever reason the control mech can't get at it. But this should be fine deployment. As to wherever the robots go, they shouldn't be able to block us on turn one. They should probably wind up somewhere over here or somewhere over there, and we'll just have to deal with them later. Okay, that's pretty good. That's basically what I wanted to happen. Kind of. So, we don't have the extra range, so I can't really... If I try and make you go over here, you're going to attack first, and I can't really get the bonus damage anyway. I guess I could control mech you over here and have you hit you, but I really don't want you to actually be alive. Yeah, I don't think we're going to be able to get much friendly fire going on over here. And I can't control mech this either, because that's not powered, so it can't move. Okay, good to know. So, basically I'm just trying to figure out, is there something better I can do than killing two enemies? I guess I can kill three enemies. I could kill this and this, and control mech this over here to kill that. And I can only do that by blocking a spawn, which I don't like to do on turn one, but it might still be good anyway. Because at least we'll have control of the field. Like, next turn we'll have this enemy and one inactive robot and this. So it'll be 3-on-3. Alright, I think that's worth it. Like, everything else I'm looking at is just worse, I think. And the other thing is I don't like this being right here. That's my other worry about this situation. I guess it's not too late. Like, I could, well, no. I can't both kill this and, get that to happen. That's the problem. So I want this to be close by, and then I also want this to have a shot at one of these. But this is the only place it can actually take a shot at one of these from. Like, is it worth setting this on fire anyway? Like, it will actually die next turn. So, it'll still do the thing that it's supposed to do now. This would be one way I could have my cake and eat it too. So, this would die next turn. It might still web my smog mech, but that would be fine. I could ignore that. Then we kill one of these, and so effectively next turn it's this alive and this alive. And I prefer that. Okay. This is why you have to double check these sorts of things. Every now and then you actually do get something that's better. Alright. By carefully considering our turn one, I think we have control of the situation. Even if this was a really nasty enemy, life would be good. So I guess that means we're killing this, letting that... Well, it can't just let it burn. We need to actually kill this for that to burn. Okay. So there's the rub. And this doesn't have a direct shot on this. If we move this out of the way, then I could jet away from it. Thrust away from it. On the other hand, if I control this away from its building, then I can ignore it until the turn that I actually kill this on. But I'd rather just get a 2-for-1 this way and kill this and thus kill that. So this can't kill this, and this could move it out of the way. So I guess the play is to move this over here into the fire. Oh, but it can't reach. Ah, that's what we need that range upgrade for. So I guess we'll move this out of the way, kill this, and then kill this, I guess? Yeah, so this will still be alive next turn, but it's relatively benign. It's like a hornet that can't move as far. So we'll block that. That's also good evidence that the self-damage happens on this tile and not on that tile. So this is dead. This will help block up this section. And we'll have four enemies next turn. That's not quite as good. Let's see if we can improve that. We should be able to do better. So that still only is able to move two. If we go here and move this, we could block a spawn. I guess that's really how we're going to come out ahead here, is if we can do everything that we did this turn, or something similar at least, and block a spawn. Yeah, I think that's actually going to be the real benefit of this, upgrading this plus one move, is we can do all sorts of things where we take an enemy on the front lines that's attacking a building, move it back to the back lines, and have it block its own spawn. That's a two-for-one right there. A very, very handy one. I guess another thing we could do... No, like, there's... The only way we can actually kill this turn is if we directly artillery unit it. Otherwise, we want to kill this, and that's basically the same thing. So we might as well kill this. But there's just not really much productive that we can do with this. We could light ourselves on fire. That makes this at least... That makes this dead. And this is easier to kill. But then I can't kill this. If I move down here and control this away, if I move this instead of this, then I can thruster away from it and wind up on top of a spawn. Maybe that's the trick. So then I need to be able to move two, so right there is the right spot. And that's reachable. Or, even better, I have it block a spawn. No, that won't kill it fast enough. This will happen first. So we do need to kill it on our turn, which means that we have to do this. So you'll survive that. This will burn. And then we need to just kill one of these two things. And I guess this has lower movement, so we want to centralize this. Okay, this is better. Now, this will die, this will die, this will be alive. We've blocked a spawn, so now it's 3-on-3. 1, 2, 3. There we go. I could have accepted that first turn I found where we would have had 4 enemies next turn. It would have been very hard to deal with. We might have been able to do it, but by searching a little bit harder, we found a way to spend 1 HP to have 1 fewer enemy next turn. And that is the correct way of doing this sort of thing. Alright, I guess we control you into fire. That'll effectively get a kill. Then we can't smoke this. We would want you to hit that, and we would want you to destroy that, but you're too far away. So I guess that means you kill this. What order is this in? It's the wrong one. Yeah, this goes last, so I can't use this to kill any of the other enemies. That's a shame. Well, the other thing that I happen to know about this squad is because it has the ability to repair using smoke, it's actually okay to let this die so long as I smoke it before the end of the mission and revive it in that way. So, if need be, I could do something like this. Thrust away from it, kill it, we'll delay by one turn, and let that happen. The problem is I would still wind up not blocking these spawns, though, so we are still under threat of having the spawns overwhelm us on the last turn. So we still need to do better than this. So we could control mech this onto a spawn, and I guess maybe that's the way to do it. But then we still need somebody to free this. So let's see. Control mech this, kill this, you go over here and kill this. Then that means we have a defunct thruster mech that's at least in an obstacle tile here. Not so great, but it's something. So we would have two mechs alive and four threats. That seems bad. That seems much worse. Where's our 2-for-1? It seems like we actually want to control this out of here. Because if we can do that, that's like paying one action to get one action back. So this is pretty efficient. Control this onto fire, kill it, free this up. Now we have some area of effect ability here. The problem is, once I do that, that all of a sudden, like, this becomes an issue. I do note that I can move this, though. Only by 2. I don't want to suffer a laser bot to live, but would that help? No. Then we still have this situation we have to fix. Like, the problem is just that the thruster mech is out of position. And I didn't have enough foresight, I guess, to put any smoke on this column. So, let's see. If I do this, I control this and put this here. Then you don't have enough move to go here, so you would go here and shoot this. Then to prevent you from doing this, you would have to kill yourself here on this tile. And so we would have a 1 HP artillery unit, 3 other units, and this mech would be dead. I would have to waste an action to revive it. Ideally, I guess I would want something like being able to smoke this tile and this tile so that, like, I can get a 2-for-1 next turn where I fixed a problem over here and revived that, and that would be enough. But I don't see any way of lining that up ahead of time. So, yeah, I think we're just out of luck because I let this get webbed and because both of these are in the front. That's a classic mistake. One of these should be in the center, able to cover the other one. I'm just double-checking everything else that we can do here, because the control mech has a tremendous amount of potential, even at this unupgraded state. But I think we're just simply not there. So I guess we just let this take its shot, then. I think we're just going to accept having one building damage. We'll block this spawn, and then we'll have... we'll still have 4 enemies next turn. That's harsh. Alright, we should be an adequate distraction for at least one of these, though. Alright, there goes the perfect run. Perfect runs are hard to do, folks. You've really got to account for everything when you do them. Alright, we've gotten there. Now we have 2 actions we can actually just afford to ignore, so we are basically golden. And again, after spending the entire game being trained to think that you can't move into smoke, this squad is all about moving into smoke. I'm going to just go ahead and assume you can't control mech a dead mech either by the same kinds of rules. Just trying to look for if there's some way I can kill this, but I think not. You know, like, we got that killed. We just don't have quite enough direct damage to get this killed. Oh, that's right. It can't actually move through our own mechs. That's also going to be something we're going to have to keep in mind for later. Okay, but we can move this here, and then we can thruster all the way out here, and that will work. We definitely did not do 3 damage there. We did 3 damage, we did not do 4. We might have done a lot of damage overall in this mission with that, but definitely not all at once. Okay. Well, we'll definitely get that achievement legitimately sometime later. I think, if I remember right, I think that's a bug somebody reported, so I guess that isn't fixed in the current version yet. That's fine. At least it's a bug in our favor. Okay. Thematic, perhaps, but I guess if anything, this is the mech we would want it on. Okay. So now it's the legal move on the last turn of the mission to reverse thrusters ourselves to death, and we don't have to care about it. Okay, this should be easier. Yeah, 2 1 HP minions, just 3-on-3 to begin with. No extra complications. This is a pretty open map, too, so area of effect on this area should be pretty helpful to us. We just have to make sure, basically, that our artillery doesn't get webbed. So something like this might be pretty good. Or maybe something like this. Ooh, I don't like that kind of mobility restriction, though. So maybe something like... I want this to be on the front line, but I also don't want to have to worry about this being webbed either. On the other hand, if it does get webbed, then we could always smoke the leader rather than setting it on fire, but I absolutely do want to light the leader on fire on the first turn. Because, as you've seen, like, we have 2 big sources of damage, and they're both kind of awkward. One that doesn't push the enemy, and the other one that does self-damage. Still, though, we might be able to manage with this sort of thing. Cover this square, cover... like, Beetle Leader just walking straight up here and decided to attack this at point blank. I guess ideally, like, maybe we want to be able to thrust our mech away from it. But if this gets webbed here, then we have also certain limitations, so... maybe this is better. Yeah, this lets you go wherever you need to go and, like, go here and thruster our way this way. And then you can control, and then if, like, these are the 2 squares at which this can get webbed, and we can cover both of them. I guess that'll have to be good enough. Like, there's varying... okay, great. We can ignore the boss. We are free to, for example, light it on fire. In fact, we can get a 2-for-1. In fact, we could control mech this over here to have the boss kill its underling, and that would be quite fine. All Alright, this all looks good. That will happen first, but I still wanted to take this shot anyway, just because those are excellent places to put smoke. Alright, so far so good. That's the other nice thing about these mosquitoes, is because they have such low movement speed, I don't have to worry about one of them spawning here and then zipping all the way up here. Like, they only have four move. Alright, so no way I can get the control mech all the way down here to fix that, but, just moving out of the way and letting nature take its course would be pretty good. Can't quite kill it this turn, though. So I guess we're looking at something like this, but if I do this, then I don't even need to damage it directly. I guess I could light this on fire. Like, what's the worst that'll happen? Eventually I'll probably want to move this into smoke someday, right? Then I could get one damage, and then, I would get two damage, I would do this attack first, and then I would light it on fire, so we'd have a total of three damage and fire. But that wouldn't work because it's not going to be lit on fire. Okay. Smoldering Scion is still doing its job. We only have one weapon that does fire, but it is still being that kind of problem. In that case, I guess we're better off just lighting one of these tiles on fire or something, and then just accepting two damage and smoke being enough. So I guess we can get a bonus damage this way. Like, we'll do this, and then we'll use our otherwise useless, control to do this. Everybody's working together. So there we go. Now we have two enemies on fire for free. We're getting a nice repair job here. Life is good. Can I just thruster away from this to kill it? Not quite. It will not be lit on fire again. Still probably worth it, though. Then I guess we control mech this to block a spawn, and then we just take a pot shot with this thing and call it a day. And if anything, I guess we'll kill the boss, sure. So now we have a 1 HP enemy here, a 1 HP enemy here. This enemy's on fire, so it'll be dead next turn, and this one is already lit on fire. Okay, I think we have control again. So, plenty of priorities, like plenty of interesting options for that first core upgrade. Like, it would be perfectly reasonable to put one extra core into movement on this to start out with. We could certainly use it. We have two melee range, effectively, weapons, which is always a bit of a concern. This will work out. We kill that, and we make a field of fire to move this into. And then we can't quite kill that, but that's okay. Alright, good enough. Alright, not quite an absolutely perfect island, but certainly a good enough one. Zenith is impressed. Well, we don't want Ralph. Sorry, Ralph. Not this time. Okay, I guess that's the weapon we'll take then. It's not impressive, but it's good enough. It could potentially be useful. Alright, so if we... So we've got two different options here. We can either buy two reactor cores and kind of waste this one, like we'll spend it on grid power. Or we sell the shield tank and the grid charger, and we can buy three cores. Or we sell both of these and we pick up one of these, or we would sell one of these, I guess. We'd probably sell, like, the grid charger, I guess. Because hopefully we wouldn't be taking that much damage in the first place. So we'd sell one of these, pick up one of these, which are both off-class. That's awkward, but still potentially very useful. I mean, they're both pushing options, is I guess what I'm getting at here. So yeah, either invest heavily into our core mechanics or get another option. And I'm thinking probably just have the cores, because all of these are excellent with upgrades. Like, there's plenty of ways in which we can make use of those extra cores to become more powerful. So, I think that is actually what we want to go with. I mean, I guess we can demonstrate this briefly in the, grid area. Sure, we can undo all this. I'm suspecting that this works, like, it's just a single one-damage melee option. And it's one use, makes sense. So if we do this, yeah, it is melee range, and it doesn't push. So, there is some use for that, but obviously it's, pretty niche. When we're looking for a consistent damage option for this one, when this option is not good enough, then this is not really gonna fit the bill. Alright. Let's really put a lot of faith in this starting equipment. This is not usually something I do that often. I like having the extra options, but since everything has lined up in this fashion, I think it's the way to go. So, we want one more move on that. That will help a lot. We probably just want one more move on each of these as well. Like, three damage will be enough for now. This is going to be very hard to make use of. Like, this is probably the one upgrade I want to skip out on this squad. Because it costs three cores, it only does one more damage, and it's very, very restrictive as to how you would use it. You have to be able to have the room to move that far, and you have to accept moving that far away from the battle. Like, you'll be moving four squares away from your target. So that has the potential to put you way off course and far away from the battle. So I think just getting these essentials will be far kinder to us. Like, these will be useful in the future. This will be very, very nice eventually. But I don't want to quite invest in this yet. Like, we need... This needs to be able to actually reach its targets in order to do its work. Alright, next time, one of these other islands.